Welcome to Kari's Conscious Living. Are you ready to meditate with Kari? Make sure that you're laying down, you're comfortable, everything is just right in your room, the lights are just right, your PJs are comfy, you're snuggling your teddy, whatever you need to relax and let go of your day. Are you ready to listen to a story? Are you ready to meditate and relax your body? Take some deep breaths. Take in a nice, big, deep breath. And then breathe out nice and long. Take in another nice, big, deep breath all the way down to your toes. And breathe it all out. Final one, one big, deep breath. Biggest one yet. And then breathe it out. Be still, still as a statue, and as quiet as a mouse. Tucker and Leo were out on a walk. They liked to walk down the secret passage. It was a long trail close to where they lived. They met lots of different dogs on that passage, and they'd become friends with quite a few of them. On this particular day, luckily for Leo, Tucker had not met any dogs that he wanted to chew, or bite, or eat, or just tease, or do whatever he normally does. On this particular day, Leo was very happy because Tucker bumped into one of his bestest friends. His bestest friend was a pug called Bakery, and he was very, very smart. Now, he was that smart that you wouldn't think Tucker, who wasn't that smart. Leo was kind of puzzled by the whole friendship deal, to be honest with you, because Tucker was quite a simple dog, whereas Bakery was very, very complex. And every time they bumped into him, he had something very deep and interesting that he talked to them about. Leo liked him too, because Leo always learned a lot from him. On this day, Bakery was rolling around in the biggest muddy puddle that you've ever seen. It had been raining for 3 days where Tucker and Leo lived, and everything was muddy and wet, but it smelled really good, like the earth was all fresh and clean. Bakery was rolling and rolling and rolling in the dirt, and he was absolutely covered in mud, which to Leo was quite petrifying, but to Tucker, it looked awesome. Tucker jumped headfirst into the puddle with Bakery.
Hi, Bakery! Hi, Bakery! Oh my gosh, this is so much fun! I love puddles! I love these kind of puddles because they're so big and they're so wet and they're so dirty, and you can get every single bit of your fur covered in mud, and it feels so yummy. And then when it dries, it gets really, really crispy, and then Mum and Dad always complain, and then they have to bath me, but I really don't care because I love it!
Tucker started rolling and rolling like an alligator over and over and over in the puddle, and it didn't take him like 2 seconds before he was absolutely covered in mud, and all you could see with his eyes and his big wide open mouth as he was talking to Bakery. Bakery said,
I adore muddy puddles. You know why I adore muddy puddles, my friends? I adore them because they're very, very grounding.
Leo said, grounding? What do you mean by grounding?
Oh, let me explain, said Bakery. Grounding is when you connect to the earth. You connect your body, your feet, your paws, your head, your body, your feet, your paws, your head, whatever it is that's laying or touching the earth is grounding. Did you know that as living beings, we're made up of an energy of electricity and magnetism?
No, said Leo. Tucker said,
I I'm not made up of energy. I'm made up of fur and muscles and bones and flesh and some like juicy bits and maybe a bit of blood, because I've seen blood sometimes when I hurt myself and I get boo-boos. So yeah, I'm made up of all them things. I'm not made up of energy.
Bakery said,
just listen. I'll explain. You're made up of energy. People are made up of energy. Rocks are made of energy. Trees are made of energy. The whole Mother Earth is made of energy. And we live in a very healthy way when we're connecting to that energy. That energy you can call grounding, or you can call it earthing. That's when you walk with your bare paws on the earth or on the sand or in the water or on the beach or in the snow or on the rocks or on the mud, like we're doing right now. Tucker, Leo, you should join us.
Oh, I don't think so, said Leo.
Tucker said, come on, Leo, stop being so boring. You might really like it. It feels really nice on your fur. It's all cool and refreshing. And you feel like you've got like a whole body mask or something like that. Like, like when you see Mum put those masks on her face and all you can see is her mouth and her teeth and her eyes. Well, it feels like that for your entire body. It's really nice. Do it, Leo.
Leo was in a surprisingly brave mood on this particular day, and he popped his front paws in the puddle and squelched his toes and the pads of his paws and his nails into the puddle, and it actually felt just like Tucker said. It was fresh and wet and kind of like refreshing on your skin. He put his back paws in the puddle, and then he decided to just go for it.
He rolled in the muddy puddle.
Tucker couldn't believe it.
Oh my golly golly! I don't believe it! You're so brave today, Tucker! Go for it, go for it! Roll, roll, it feels really nice on your fur! Keep rolling, keep rolling!
Leo kept rolling and rolling, and it did. It felt really nice on his fur. Very, very refreshing. And he felt very calm inside. Leo never feels calm inside, but he felt calm. He said to Bakery, is it normal to feel calmer? Bakery said,
oh yes, you'll feel calm, you'll be able to focus more, you'll be able to just center yourself and feel very, very just relaxed. And also, it helps with your health, it keeps you healthy, and it keeps your fur vibrant and shiny, and it keeps your muscles strong. You wouldn't believe something as simple as grounding on Mother Earth, just connecting with bare paws or rolling in the mud like we're doing, could do something so scientifically amazing as this. It's all about the energy, said Bakery.
All three of them were rolling and rolling and rolling, just like giant crocodiles or alligators roll in the water. They were rolling over and over, and then they stopped and just kind of laid and chilled in it, like they were laying in a spa or something. Leo said, how come you know so much about this, Bakery?
I read books. I read lots of books. Books are very good, you know. They have so much information in them. You could learn absolutely anything with a book. You could learn self-help with a book. You can learn how to cook with a book. You can learn how to fix your car with a book. You can learn another language with a book. I speak French, German, Italian, and Russian.
Leo said, wow, that's amazing. Tucker said,
can you do some other, like, languages then? Can you talk to us that's like in a different language so we wouldn't understand you?
Bakery, the dog, said,
well, what would be the point in that? If you can't understand me, there's no point. No, I'd rather keep that for my dog friends that can speak other languages. For now, let's just ground.
All three dogs started rolling and rolling and rolling once again. The mud was splashing all over the place. And then it became time when it was time to go home. The dogs, obviously, had to have a bath. Leo was not happy about that at all. But he did decide, with how calm he felt and how focused he felt and how less nervous and anxious he felt having to have a bath was worth rolling around in the muddy puddle. And when they were all clean and fresh and smelt nice and shampooy, they lay down on the big dog beds and decided to relax and take a nice big nap. Both Leo and Tucker closed their eyes. They took in big, deep breaths. Tucker's tongue fell out of the side of his mouth. Leo's front paws started to twitch, as if he was running or rolling in the muddy puddle once again. Tucker started to make dream sounds, as if he was barking and talking in his dreams. They got sleepier and sleepier and sleepier, until eventually both of them were very, very still, making snoring noises, completely relaxed and at peace, feeling very, very grounded and connected to Mother Earth.